Let's head up to Sweet Home, Alabama. Talk to my good friend, Joseph Goodman, sports columnist up in the great state of Alabama. You can read all of his columns at al.com. He's also the author of a great new book entitled We Want Bama. If you are an Alabama fan, you got to get this. Joe Goodman, how do you get this book? How can we get this book?
Mike, man, you're playing my theme song. God, I love
Yeah.
You can get the book on Amazon. You can get it on bookshop.org. You can probably get it in a local bookstore down there. It's not just for Alabama fans. Really, you know, it is just a book that talks a lot about the history of the South and how a lot of social factors were destined to crash into each other in the pandemic year of 2020. You know, the history of racial injustice in the South, you know, the pandemic and the love of college football all created this environment in Alabama that was unlike anything, you know, we have ever experienced. And it was a defining year and football season in Alabama. So I wanted to chronicle that in a book. And yeah. Now, Nick Saban wants to blow up college football and make it professional.
Yeah, and all right, correct me if I'm wrong, all right? Correct me if I'm wrong. I used to not like Nick Saban that much. I thought he was just, you know, this cutthroat football coach. But I really do think Nick Saban... Now, and again, I like him a lot more than I used to. I think Nick Saban really does care about the sport of college football, and I think he cares about his players a lot. He wants what's best for his players, and am I wrong in that?
No, you're not wrong. You know, he definitely cares about his players, absolutely. Mm-hmm. And you get older, you start having different perspectives on things, and I think that happens to everybody, and definitely that's happened for Nick Saban, you know, when it comes to a lot of his opinions on, you know, the health of college football and things like that. But, yeah, definitely he's still cutthroat.
What do you think about his idea of, again, he says college football as it is not sustainable. What does he even mean by that? I mean, college football is not going to wither up and die if NIL keeps going the way it's going, right?
I don't think anyone knows what the future is going to be like for college football right now. I think a lot of people, including Nick Saban, are worried about their position in the sport. With these changing landscapes of NIL collectives that are cropping up. And, yeah, they're having to adjust like everybody else. I don't know what he means by it being sustainable. It seems like – so he is suggesting if Alabama is going to have an NIL collective that pays players, then Alabama should pay all of its players equally, okay? Mm-hmm. Because – he said he didn't want to create a caste system within his team. You know, I mean, that's a coach thinking out loud about what's best for a team. And that makes a lot of sense, you know. But also, that sounds a lot like pro football, okay? So if these teams are just going to pay every single player to circumvent, you know, through some kind of third-party NIL collective, just to circumvent tax exemptions, then I mean, it doesn't seem like that's going to last. I mean, there's so many reasons that will just not last.
Yeah, and Nick Saban also brought up, you know, hey, if it's got to be a two-way street, players, if players are going to commit to a program and get paid, they need to sign a contract so they can't just enter the transfer portal when they become unhappy. What do you think about that idea?
Yeah, I think that's a good idea. In theory, you know, right now, is a player gonna like get some money and then go into the portal and to try to get more money? Like, I really don't know about all these what if scenarios that are being thrown around right now. You know, what I definitely do know is that all of the money is being thrown at these players from these NIL collectives, and it's changing the way recruits pick teams. And that's the bottom line when it comes to Nick Saban. Nick Saban is Nick Saban because he can recruit better than anyone else. And when his ability to recruit players is affected by a new rule in college football, then, you know, he's going to voice his opinion on it being bad for college football. Now, does their NIL collective think this is unsustainable? Like, I don't really know. Maybe Florida's NIL is going to be able to pool together more money than Alabama's and get players that they weren't able to get before. So, you know, we'll see what happens. I mean, this is such a transitional period for college football. It's really kind of extraordinary to cover it as a journalist because you have so many different elements at play here: the transfer portal, the NIL collectives, the changing landscape of the conferences with Texas and Oklahoma coming to the SEC. Like, how is that shift going to affect major college football down the line? You know, are we going to have? Is it gonna go to like 60 teams or 50 teams? Are they gonna just break off and be actually become professional and kind of like a minor league for the NFL? I mean, you know, these are all things that I think are being talked about and discussed. And I do know that Alabama is gonna be the number one ranked team though when the season starts.
Here's what sort of confuses me about Saban's stance. All right, you would think, all right, Alabama's Alabama. Players are going to want to go there anyway because they know that Saban's going to develop them for the NFL. But you would think that with these NIL collectives, that Alabama, with that rabid fan base, you would think that their NIL collective would just about trump anybody. So why is Nick Saban even worried? I mean, he's got the advantage of being Nick Saban, and he's probably got more boosters and fans than anybody.
Well, Alabama, Alabama shot itself in the foot. I'm talking about the state of Alabama right now.
Mm-hmm.
They've gotten Alabama and Auburn have gotten a late jump on the NIL collective situation because Alabama's legislature was very quick to write this NIL act when it first happened, and they actually wrote into that legislation ways to prohibit boosters from interacting and buying players the way these NIL collectors are doing now. So they had to go back and get all of that repealed, okay? So they've been busy they finally got it repealed in February, and I mean, it's just so ridiculous. Like, imagine Alabama and Auburn writing legislation into, you know, and then having to like, oh wait, no, we don't want these laws anymore, okay? So they have finally gotten this NIL act taken off the books, and now they're behind. You know, you see Tennessee is ahead, Florida is ahead, you know, Oregon is ahead, places like this. Texas A&M is ahead of everybody, okay? So, yeah, Alabama has a lot of fans, they have a lot of boosters, but they're playing catch-up right now, so we'll see how that shakes out for the class of 2023. You know, like, is Arch Manning the quarterback that everyone wants? Is he going to go to the highest bidder? Like, I don't know. That's, I mean, he's the big fish out there, right? he's the big recruit that everyone wants, that they think is going to revolutionize and make them national champions. So, you know, maybe Alabama thinks they need to get this NIL collective situation squared away so they can offer Arch Manning a bunch of money.
Although Arch Manning's family's so rich anyways, I mean, does he even need a bunch of money? Wouldn't he go to the best program that would develop him the best? I would think, right?
You know what I've come to learn about people with a lot of money, Mike?
What? They want more?
They want more money.
Oh, wow. Joe Goodman, you can read all of his stuff at AL.com. Tell people how they can get your book, We Want Bama Again.
Yeah, you can go on Amazon. Just look up We Want Bama, or you can go to bookshop.org. You can get it anywhere online or in a bookshop.
There you have it, Joe Goodman. Joe, we appreciate it. Thank you so much for joining us this morning.
All right, Mike. Take care.
Straight ahead. I know Mark Daniels has some theories on what Nick Saban said. We'll get into that, the NBA, Major League Baseball, NBA stuff, all that coming your way on The Bridge.